Good, thanks for having us. Thanks for taking the time and in your busy day to listen to our story. My name is Joep Gerrits from Calabrio. I'm a strategic partner director for Boucher & Souter and Cisco in general. I will expand a little bit first on, you know, what Jürgen said about changing times, and that's the topic of our presentation demonstration. The changing times and expectations on customer service departments, and how Calabrio and Boucher & Souter can help you manage these things. First, a little bit about Calabrio. Axel already mentioned Teleopti. Teleopti, more known in your region than Calabrio probably is. We acquired Teleopti Workforce Management a year and a half ago and established ourselves with this very fine product in the European market. Calabrio itself is headquartered in Minneapolis. It's in the Midwest, as the Americans call it. It's already snowing and freezing over there, as it does 9 months out of the year. We have multiple headquarters around the globe. The European EMEA headquarters is actually in Stockholm, we are a global player in workforce engagement management software, more commonly known as workforce optimization and analytics, recognized leader by various analysts in the market. I've been in this industry for over 25 years, working on with customers and partners on workforce optimization solutions and helping clients to improve their business. I'm doing this presentation together with my colleague Andreas. Andreas?
Yes, hello. Andreas Marx, based in Germany, sales engineer mainly for the DACH region, but also focusing on other regions in EMEA. And also 20 years in the contact center solutions and working 15 years as workforce management consultant, so in the delivery. What is important to me, and that is also part of that PowerPoint slide, is the local presence that we have. So you mentioned the headquarters based in Minneapolis in the US, but the workforce management, which is one of the core parts of our suite, the development of that is coming from Teleopti with main parts, and that is based in Stockholm, which makes it a lot more easier to cover things like German regulations or European regulations, European contracts, European way of scheduling. So that is all that we can offer you. We have a dedicated sales team for the DACH region, and of course with our local partners we also can provide German support in the area. With that, back to you, Joep.
Okay. So quickly, the agenda for our hour. I'm going to talk a little bit about the state of the contact center. As Jürgen pointed out, you know, COVID has had a big impact, not only on us as a company and our partners, but definitely also on the contact center industry across the globe. Where they used to be organized in working from offices and providing customer service there, you know, starting the beginning of the epidemic, you know, everybody moved home, and there was a need first for getting connectivity going, and then, you know, once that was set up and on the control, yeah, then these challenges in organizing and managing start coming. So I'm going to give you a bit of feedback on that, what we learned from our customers and partners around the globe. Then I'm going to spend some time. I'm going to introduce our solution, Calabrio One, which can help you cope with these different circumstances. And, you know, I could talk by PowerPoint for 8 hours about that, but not to bore you, I'm going to move quickly into demonstrations. First, I'm going to demonstrate the workforce optimization solution, or personnel Einsatzplanung, as it's more commonly known in Germany for, followed by Calabrio quality management demonstration. And then at the end, you know, we're going to wrap up a little bit, and then I have a few minutes for questions. So the state of the contact center, as said, when COVID started and people were forced to move into the home office, it was quite a exciting period, especially for partner to enable customers doing that, but more so from a technology and communication perspective. After a few weeks, that was all organized in a good way. And then you're stuck with sometimes thousands of employees working in a home office environment without direct supervision as before. What we did, first of all, enable a lot of our existing clients with just providing what was missing in their solution to manage these situations. But also then, we started talking to them about, okay, how are you coping? How are you managing? To get this knowledge and findings, which each individual customers was trying to figure out, get them across to other clients as well. To make it more scientific approach, we also engaged with a research company called Gravel Research, who actually did an in-depth interview with over 300 contact center managers across the U.S. and the U.K., across different industries, and we came out, with a white paper called "The State of the Contact Center: Embracing the Evolving World of Work." In a couple of minutes, coming minutes, I'm going to share some of the findings with you, but we're going to provide the whole white paper via our partner Boeg & Sutter to you, so you can read up on your at your own time and own pace, or distribute it amongst colleagues who might be also interested in these. Couple of findings. Customer expectations. We asked, actually contact center managers about customer expectations, what they have seen and experienced in the past months. Has it become more? Are the customers expecting more? Are they, actually less, or has it stayed the same? So a lot of, managers, about 63%, actually said, yeah, after, the initial search, what they see is, and that aligns with what Jürgen said in a prior presentation, they expect more channels to communicate with the company. It's a long trend of, involving multiple channels, omni channels, into the customer service organizations with chats, with social media, of course, email, beyond telephony. But new expectations have risen, like video meetings, etc. And that has also been so because sometimes, customers are no longer available via the phone. So where, prior Corona, maybe 20% of all traffic was other channels than voice, this has hugely expanded because if people have to wait for multiple minutes in a queue before they get served, they prefer to just drop you a note in a chat or in an email or, on a social post. So there's been a huge push for this by customers to be really truly get served in an omni-channel way. What they also expect is to get more emotional empathy in agent interactions, and that has a lot to do with COVID, which is still going on. In the beginning, what we heard was that, the customer satisfaction actually didn't really suffer because customers, appreciated and understood that the customer service people were also working from home. So the customers were being forced to work from home and the service agents were worked from home. So the customer was actually empathetic to the service agent for that. But what we see in, as this epidemic is has continued for, multiple moment, we just see that, the customers get more emotional, and where, small issues and challenges they have turn into big issues and challenges just because, they have like a tighter fuse, as we call in the Netherlands. And you know, they already forgot, because we're so well organized in the industry, that the person they're talking to also sits in a home office. So they just expect, as always, that they will be served in the best way. And they expect, you know, the agent to understand that it's a painful period for the customer, working from home, managing, you know, his home affairs with kids at homeschooling in some countries, and then still being able to do the work, and then still, you know, have challenges on other pieces. So they expect more emotional empathy, because there's just more emotion in general in our societies today. What also has raised is customers that, you know, expect more complex, they have more complex requests and questions. That's a trend which has been going on for a long time, that, you know, most organizations have moved, you know, the easy topics in sort of a self-service mode, either via the internet or via, you know, apps they give to their clients. So it was already a trend of, you know, the traffic and the questions that hit, you know, live agents get more complex. Now, during the COVID period, of course, that has been fueled, because every physical outlet of a customer is closed. So where sometimes people would go with complex questions to their banks or to their insurance brokers or those kind of organizations, now they only have the customer service department. So yeah, that the complex questions volumes are really going up really, really fast. So this puts a new challenge on customer service organizations, as you know, they need more knowledgeable agents or better support for agents in that regard. So what also came across is that was really dominant was that, you know, it was also something Jürgen referred to. This is not going away. I mean, this is a trend which has been, you know, been risen by COVID or expedited quicker, but it's not going away. These new channel demands, you know, once people get a feel for video calling in the beginning, you know, we're all struggling a bit, you know, working from home and doing video calls. The same is happening on the customer side. Once people get used to it, they start to appreciate it. So these new channels which customers are using now, yeah, are there to stay. And the volume that people are using are, you know, getting bigger and bigger. So this is not going to change. Also, remote working is here to stay. You know, when we talk to managers across the world, you know, the study itself was done in the US and the UK, but, you know, in all our engagement with clients around the globe in different countries, including in the DACH region, you know, we've continuously benchmark the results and see is this also typical in local regions. And yeah, I mean, yes, this is here to stay. Maybe not, you know, in the way, probably not in the way, you know, we're currently working, that everybody home works 100% home in a mixed model, but, you know, it's definitely here to stay. Because agents have settled into their new work life, and you know, a lot of managers, you know, see, you know, that, you know, agents appreciate things, not 100% working from home maybe, but what they expect is, okay, you know, it might go back to mixed models. Maybe there are people who want to work 100% in an office environment, and that's fine, but they expect the majority of the agents willing to actually work in a mixed model where they work from home 2 or 3 days and be in the office 2 or 3 days, something like that. Or even working with agents who just say, yeah, I would like to permanently work from home or 4 days and have, you know, every other week a day at the office to stay connected. So those models are coming, and, you know, in a lot of countries, these models have been there longer. In other countries, there has been more of a culture of working in an office environment completely. But it's the same as with these new channels. Once people get a taste for it, they appreciate, you know, the things that are happening. Also, because what actually, you know, people or managers are saying is that the expected dip in productivity is actually not happening. Yes, you know, conversations take longer, and, you know, maybe while they are actually on the phone, you know, agents that working from home might be a little bit less productive. But what they've seen is that things as, you know, short-term illness, people reporting in sick for 1 or 2 days, that's almost completely gone. And yeah, you can think about, you know, what was the real reason behind, you know, people calling sick for 1 day. Was that true illness, or had they to solve, you know, things at home? Because even in, you know, epidemic times like COVID, you know, people are just not, you know, reporting in for 1 or 2 days sick as they ever did before. So the overall productivity, if you take that into account, actually stays the same. So agents are, you know, happy and, you know, are also more flexible. The new way of working, you know, as Jürgen described, that, you know, people work around their private lives instead of, you know, going into an office and they're working there for, you know, 8 hours a day. Oh, you know, they're available to work, you know, in the morning, then for lunchtime, they have an extended lunch to take care of the kids, in the afternoon a few hours, and maybe after dinner even. So it's getting more and more flexible. We've even seen companies already talking to us about what they call an Uber model. And, you know, how to translate that is maybe, okay, Uber, you know, how they work with their drivers. Basically, you know, they are self-employed and they make themselves available in an app to take to work for Uber. Now, we've actually talked to clients who actually want to see, you know, if they can, you know, part of their workforce could be like that. You know, maybe students who just, you know, make themselves available to take conversations at appropriate times for them to, you know, accommodate for peaks, for instance. So that is, you know, all kind of things changing on the workforce. And, you know, the thing is, you know, by providing this flexibility, it actually increases employee satisfaction because they feel that they are, you know, more part of the process instead of, you know, sitting at the end and just, you know, get a schedule or whatever. It also has the benefit, you know, that you have a more flexible service force. So, you know, when traffic changes differently, you know, it's easy, much more easily to accommodate for that. Agent development. As conversations get more complex and topics get more complex and the customer demand more empathy from people, yeah, quality management as a concept is more important than ever. And what we've seen is that, you know, basically every, you know, a lot of people who are already using this kind of technology are using it more or actually have started using it. In the past, you know, you had organizations who said, yeah, we do quality management, for instance, by side coaching. Now that concept is almost completely gone because you have agents working from home. So you cannot do that side-by-side coaching of agents. To help them coach and do a better, more effective job. So people are looking for automation in that area. Now, more evaluations, you know, if you do, it takes more time. So people are looking towards predictive analytics or artificial intelligence fused quality management using technology to make, you know, the work of quality managers more, you know, easier, more automated, so they actually can, you know, take a higher workload on. So the importance of quality management really to as a solution to do better coaching, better training of agents, and in that way being able to deliver a constant excellent customer service, because that is basically what customers are asking for, is a big necessity. And that's also there to stay. And again, you know, this might differ per region because we know the whole concept of quality management and recording is not well adopted in every region around the world in the same manner. But we see, you know, companies even in regions where before it was seen as, yeah, we don't want a big brother is watching you technology. We see them embracing it because they realize it's not, you know, about looking for bad behavior of people. It's about coaching and learning and developing agents to do a smarter, better job. Because if you have good conversations as agents, if you are equipped to provide good service, that is motivating for yourself as well. And that means you have better calls, you have nicer calls instead of, you know, more difficult calls. And in that way, yeah, if you're an you become an engaged agent with your customers, and engaged agents, yeah, create engaged customers. So different kind of expectations and changes on the contact center operations, and what is actually, you know, yeah, what they are all saying, all these managers are saying, is it's here to stay. It's not going away. It's not okay in 6 months when all these, you know, new medicines coming to the market that we're going back to business as usual, because the genie is out of the bottle in this regard. Let me introduce you to Calabrio One, our solution, which is, you know, actually a smart, digital, and easy to use solution across these different domains of quality management, workforce management, call recording, and analytics. Let me quickly, you know, walk you through the different components of the suite and what they're being used for. Now, call recording has always been there, most cases for compliance reasons. Think banks, insurance companies, traders, where you actually are having a transaction on the in the communication or an advice, which is supposed to be recorded as evidence for, in case there's a dispute on what actually happened during the call. That's all it does. Huh? It's just recording. It gives you tools to search back and replay conversations. And then you store it for a certain period of time. Sometimes it's a year. Sometimes you're forced to store it for 7 years or even longer. Now, on top of that, you can start, you know, we've started adding functionality. First stop is, you know, quality management. It's using those recordings basically to look what is going on in the conversation itself. Look at the content. How is the agent doing the conversations? Is he using the right tools to answer the questions for the which the customer throws at him? Does he show empathy? Does he really understand the issue? Does he use the right questioning techniques to really help the customer in the best way possible? All to make the customer experience as flawless as possible. That's what we're aiming at. And it's been caught in an evaluation form. And then, you know, you have a coaching session with the agents to see, okay, where is your room for improvement? So you are being able and enabled to do more smoothless conversations, basically, and providing, having more pleasant conversations with customers. And that's actually what agents want, right? Because they're also people. Then the middle component in the suite is called workforce management, or in German, as said before, Personnel Einsatzplanung, or PEP. In short, what the technology is all about, in essence, it is about, you know, making sure you have the right amount of agents with the right skills at the right time available to handle customers contacting the organization. Now, what has becoming more and more important over the time, because that was the core functionality already 20, 30 years ago, but more and more important with these kind of technology, is how you engage also the agent in this process. So it's no longer, you know, okay, you need to be there and logged in at that time. No, you know, it's also about, okay, when am I available? Which preference do I have? Do I want an early start or late start? Or, you know, can I trade schedules with my peer agents? It's about holiday planning, all those things where, you know, they are actually able to influence, you know, their work schedule. And, you know, by giving them this ability to influence it, they are really becoming part of this process of planning and forecasting. So that's workforce management. Then we have a solution which is called Calabrio Advanced Reporting. It's the business intelligence layer across contact center management. Basically, it stores, you know, all kind of information out of different kind of technologies, which have to do with customer operations, and, you know, provides the ability to create dashboards, reports, real time and historical, to be used by customer service management to get a holistic picture of how well am I doing and where do I need to focus on to improve. And then on top of that, you know, we have a feature set for analytics. Analytics is not, in our world, not aiming at numbers. Analytics is actually aiming at content. So think technologies like speech analytics, diving into hundreds of thousands of conversations to try to figure out, you know, what are the main topic people are calling about? Where do we have challenges in providing services? You can all detect that in conversations between customers and agents. Because, you know, if things are not going well, the customer is going to express that in the next conversation. Going to say things like, this is the third time I'm calling about this. Why does this always go wrong with you? So he's, you know, letting you know as an agent, you know, that this is a serious issue where you've called before. Now, using artificial intelligence and smart algorithms, we can bring these topics to the top of the attention of management and also dive into, okay, what is actually going on and what do we need to improve? So it's improvement technology to provide a better customer service. And we can do that across omni channels. So we can do that across speech, text, and we also always include, you know, what's happening on the agent desktop. Not to see what the agent actually is doing, but to better, you know, get an understanding if there is an issue, where is this issue taking place in a process? Could be an issue with how we've set up CRM or our delivery system, because that's where the agent is during the conversation to figure out, you know, what the customer's challenge is. So combining these analytic capability to give, you know, not a holistic conversation of the agent and the operation, but a holistic insight actually into the interaction. And then, you know, using technology to make this possible on high volumes. Because with some of our clients, we're not talking about thousands of calls a day, we're talking about 100,000 calls a day. That's really, really difficult to do analysis on. So you need smart technology for that. So just, you know, scaling a bit back, you know, WISE looking at, you know, solutions like workforce management and quality monitoring even more important now than before. Because those are not new topics. Now, because, you know, in this, you know, COVID and post-COVID era, this new normal is here to stay, as we've seen in our research studies. And, you know, you require a workforce management solution which can handle different things, which can handle, for instance, omni-channel. I mean, usually workforce management tools look at calls. But all of a sudden, you know, the volumes in things like email, chat, co-browsing, video calling is, you know, popping up because customers want to use those channels. And we want to be able to serve those channels with the right service levels as well. So you need a workforce management tool which can actually handle these omni-channel contacts and also forecast and plan for them. So that's really important. You also need a solution which can provide you this flexibility on new work rules and new work concepts. As we talked before, you know, the concept of split shifts, working part of the day and then coming back on another part of the day. Or this Uber model I talked about, you know, that is different than ever before. So you need a WFM solution which can handle that. And, you know, an WFM solution which actually can engage in a good way with agents. So they're feeling that, you know, they're not, you know, just a resource for the company. No, they're part of this process of making excellent customer journeys. And it's also appreciated their personal circumstances and taking into account when creating schedules. They need to be part of this because at the end of the day, if they are not engaged with you as a customer, they're not going to engage with your customer, and, you know, then your end customers are not going to get this excellent experience that we're all achieving for or trying to aim for. The same is applicable to quality management solutions, right? You know, the times that have changed, that when you all had, you know, direct supervision over teams, you know, really, you know, close by yourself, when you were sitting as a manager behind your desk, you could see all the agent, have direct supervision. You know, if you saw an agent was struggling, you just walked to his desk and you plugged your headset in, then you listened in and said, okay, what's going on? Sometimes you were at the ability to barge in, you know, depending on the voice technology you were using, but that's all gone. Those times are not there anymore. You need smart tools which allow remote monitoring and do that, you know, and provide coaching to agent in that way, because the coaching of agent needs to happen in a more consistent way. As conversations get more difficult, as you know, we get these need for higher skilled agents, it's not like you have a sitting workforce which you need to upskill. Actually, it's not like you can go out to the market and recruit, you know, 1,000 rocket scientists to handle these questions. No. You have to grow your existing workforce, and coaching is a key part of that. You need a QM solution which can help you in that. And then also this omnichannel quality management. Most people think about quality management is only for voice calls. No, you're also supposed to do that for these other channels, because you can organize your QM in voice really well, but more and more conversations are in other channels. So you need to provide good quality conversations in chat. You need to be able to train people on how to become, you know, show empathy while typing text in a chat. You know, how do you get your understanding across to your customers who are using different channels? So you need quality management tools which can support you there as well. Okay, that's it from my side. And, you know, let's go into the demo.
Yes, let's get from theory to practice.
Exactly.
Do you see my screen?
Yes, we can.
Excellent. So, yeah, let me start with one of our new functions of the new Calabrio Cloud solution. So this is the full suite containing everything that Joop already explained before, analytics, quality management, and workforce management as well, as well as the recordings, of course. So, and what we see when you log in as either an agent or a supervisor or a call center manager or whatever is you start with your own dashboard. And these dashboards are a great thing. They are totally freely configurable. So, and you can easily set up whatever data you need to know that gives you a perfect overview over what is currently on in your environment. This is one example that I recently built where it shows me on this area some agent performance data, so quality management statistics. Here we get the real-time status in terms of working from home. It is more and more important to see really what the agent is doing, what real-time adherence actually is. I will come to that in a few seconds. So this is getting me some output of WFM data combined with contact center actual status of the agent. You can include any kind of pictures or here the homepage from Calabrio, the German one, so that is also possible. And we see here forecasted numbers versus actual contacts offered. What I can include in here, for example, are filters that I select only whatever I would like to see. Same story here, I get historical overview about contacts forecasted, contacts handled. All this, all the data that we have in our solution that has been either imported from a contact center platform into workforce management, or that is there from the recordings, from the analytics part, that can be all shown in here. The upper one, for example, shows me how much project time was scheduled this week, as well as meetings. Now, if you wonder why the service queue looks so odd from the forecast here, that is simply because it's made for a different time zone in the US. The view is totally configurable. The good news about that is it's very easy to configure these things. You don't need to be a kind of developer or BI expert. You basically just need to phrase whatever you want to have in a certain text. and you select the filters that you would like to see and apply all these. It is very simple. All these reports, we call that a report, what it exists of, straightforward to build. No need to learn SQL or anything like that. Now, if I'm in this view from here, I could click into the workforce management applications. We come to that in a second that I have. I can, of course, look at my recordings. Let's pick one of the ones that is pretty good. And once I open that, I get into the view that we have of the recordings. So that gives me really this contact, how it was handled. If I play that, I'm not sure if you can hear that. Probably not, because typically WebEx is taking it all back. But you see that while it is playing, you see the agent, that is the customer speaking. We have the speech to text. Stop that, it's confusing me. We have the speech to text a bit, as well as we see on demand the screen capture recording, and we have that plus the evaluation. So we get all the information in one piece and one place. It is not like we have, like some people or some competitors have, that you have to open an application to listen to the recording. You have to open a separate application for the transcription, third one for the evaluations. So all that, and Joop mentioned how important coaching is. So all that is in one place and makes it easy for whoever will do the coaching or the quality monitoring. Of course, I can pop one of these windows out, which then gets me a separate window. If I have multiple screens or so, I can move that easily to have a bigger, better view on the audio or screen recording. Let's get back in. Plus, I get, of course, if I want to, I have an integration to contact center platforms or a CRM system. I can get all the metadata that is related to this contact. All that is in place in this one ideally view, which makes it very easy for supervisors, team managers to do the quality management. I also have any kind of hold times here, so I can literally follow up how the conversation went. Pretty straightforward. Now let's get back to the workforce management part. Let's pick the right one. Oh, come on, go away. I'll take the other one. Now, we also have that for agents. This is one example of an agent view of the dashboard. Now, if an agent logs in, he can get whatever dashboard has been assigned to him or has been created for him, or maybe even he has the right to create his own dashboard. This is just giving some information about the agent. Here is his personal statistics, how much contacts he has taken for that period. Here were his best scores in from the quality management. Here were the worst scores, so he can listen to these. He gets an average of daily contacts, if that is wished and included, as well of course his schedule in workforce management. So also that is possible. If I click here, I get the next day to see what's coming on the next day, or I have that quick day view that shows me what I'm currently supposed to do, in this case phone activity at that time period. Another one very important feature that or functionality that we have is that the agent can be assigned to approve his own recordings in terms of the recording was made, was evaluated by a supervisor, but now the agent can listen to that again and can look at the evaluation scores and the evaluation results and can say, okay, I totally disagree to what you say. So that is to have some kind of fairness in there. That is not just being done by the supervisor, but he also has to agree to these. And again, if I click on one of these, it would jump directly into the recording and listen to that. Now let's have a more detailed look at what the agent actually can see in Teleopti WFM. That is the view that we have on the web, and as well, we can have that on the mobile app. Same story, he can use that mobile application to get into this. And the traditional view that he has is just a weekly view of a schedule. He sees the various activities, totally free to configure what kind of activity you would like to have. That is just a typical example. And the first thing he can do is if he met a colleague or so and they want to go to the lunch break together. Now, in COVID times, it's a bit odd, but let's say he has to arrange his break because of his kids. He can easily manage that by himself. to see, and the break will change as soon as I prove that. And the system is smart enough to also check that versus a forecast, meaning versus overstuffing, understuffing. I don't want to move my break, or I'm not allowed to move my break where already some too many other people are on a break, and I see a significant understuffing. But here I could move it to any part that is fully green and also with a light green that would be available, or in the later part in the administration section. And one simple thing of getting the employee engaged without having him too much controlled by the schedule itself. Most important for me is actually that the agent is capable of entering the preferences for, of course, only for periods that are not already scheduled. So let me please go to some different time here or some different dates. Let's pick April. Here, I applied for 5 early shifts. So I just said in on these days, I would like to work very early. Very easy, very simple way. I just mark them. Okay, I changed my mind. Oh, and this time, 5 days late, please. How much that wishes will be considered is, of course, a bit depending on the forecast, on other requirements to get some fairness in, as well as the settings, how much the planner will consider preferences, as we think. So in this example, if he's asking for a late shift, his chances to get a late shift are quite good because the typical German average agent would like to work early schedules. Now we see that there is a difference since Corona times, so that might be the case here as well. Split shifts are also possible. So I could enter something like, I would like to work a split shift. With these types that we call that shift categories, again, it's totally free and totally up to you what you ever want to configure. If I do something wrong, like having 3 days off in that week, you will see immediately some kind of warning. So the system will check whether my preferences that I enter match to my contract and my scheduled hours that I'm supposed to do. Let's say if I want to work then early on the Saturday, we are back in the good mode again. So that is, of course, a very important thing that the agent can do. Other quite important things are he's able to apply for overtime here. So he can either enter directly an overtime request, meaning that he would just work longer periods, or overtime availability, saying that the system gives him the chances to be prepared for overtime, saying I would be available on Saturday. And of course, I can see how much chances do I have to get these overtime works. So when everything is yellow, the chances to get overtime here or overtime here, no, well, I'm already overstuffed. It doesn't make any sense. But do it the other way around. It can also apply for absence. So looking at the absence probability here tomorrow, it would be actually quite okay to leave a bit earlier, to maybe do some things, especially from home, being more flexible and compensate that time in the next week or on other days. So we give the agents a certain impact on his scheduling without having a negative impact on the customer. That is one of the targets that we have. Making the agent engaged, but not a negative impact on the customer service level. And last but least, of course, besides having these various requests, the agent is capable of doing a shift trade. So in this example, my schedule would start at 7. If I want to exchange something with, let's say, with a day off with Pierre, I would simply click on Pierre. Now this will give me then, I will trade my early shift with a day off. I should also do it vice versa to get my weekly hours, unless I'm so flexible that I have something like a monthly contract hours or so. And that would be, so in this way, I would be capable again to impact my schedule, make easy changes. They can be manually approved on top by a supervisor, or can be automatically checked by the system, whether I have the corresponding skills, all these kind of things. And then the trade will happen. So we have a lot of impact on the agent besides reporting where the agent can see his reports and so on. Let me get a step back to see what the supervisor does before time runs out. So as a supervisor, As a supervisor, one of the most important things nowadays with working from home is the real-time adherence. That is my state from the contact center platform. I'm in the status not ready. I'm actually supposed to handle contacts at that time, work on the phone. So that is why I'm being out of adherence. The system will show that kind of warning or show that kind of alarm. And maybe that is one of the reasons why I'm looking at the plan, my service level should be excellent, but in real time, in reality, it isn't, because the real time, the agent does something different than he's supposed to do according to his schedule. Same here, the agent is in the state admin, but is actually not scheduled at all. In other words, he's working some time where he's not supposed to do. Might not have a negative impact on your service level, but it's also not the right thing. Besides that, as a supervisor, call center manager, or team lead, I get my intraday management. So I can compare with the number of agents, or first with the incoming traffic, let's say, the forecasted volume, the blue graph, the actual volume, the dark blue. So that will come with the contact center integration every 15 minutes and will show me what was the current state there. The average handling time that I have predicted and the real average handling time. And out of that, of course, I get something that is even more important for me as a team lead is the staffing. According to my forecast, I wouldn't need that amount of agents. I have scheduled this amount even higher, so I'm quite overstuffed in some periods, but looking at the actual volume, I will need far less if I look at that for the part of the day that's already gone. Now, what I can do in that point is, or what the software does for you, is automatically do kind of reforecast, so predicting with some AI how that develops from the past periods into the future periods. And that will even give me a chance, okay, I can send more agents on other activities. Maybe even give them some kind of compensation time, free time or so. All this good real-time or near real-time monitoring that is nowadays required, which I previously hadn't had when the agents were in the office, when I could check them just visually. So all these options are the ones I have. I can easily look at forecasting. All of the capabilities that we had with workforce management from Telopti are integrated into the new suite here as well.
Andreas, is 10 minutes left?
Yes, thanks very much for the information. I'm almost done anyway. I just want to do a quick recap. So we have that great new capability of creating dashboards, which give me all the data that I have in my Calabria One suite. Of course, if I just bought the workforce management, I will not get any kind of these data from quality monitoring or so. But everything that is either workforce management, quality monitoring, or analytics, or recording can be shown in that dashboards. And they are freely configurable to whatever you would like to have. With that, back to you, Joop.
Are you also going to demo quality management a little bit?
Okay, I think I did that very briefly in the beginning. So we had the one view that gives it all the data. So you could see the call itself. You can listen to that recording. You see the screen recording. You can have here the transcription, so the speech to text. You can also find in these speech to text looking for key phrases that you would like to see there or would like to find out, and you can categorize the calls on these key phrases. And most of important, the evaluation board that gives me and then the option to really do an evaluation on did the agent do these kind of things that you would like to see.
Okay. And this screen recording is optional, right?
The screen recording is optional, yes.
Yeah, for those customers who don't want to use it.
Precise. as well as the speech to text, the transcription is also optional.
Yes, and one thing I found interesting is that you can even record several screens, right? And then you can switch when you play back, you can switch between the screens. So in case you have two monitors for the agent, which is a really nice feature, and also how it's easy to switch between those two.
Yes, I think this one has just one recording. Yeah, it's just one screen here. But in fact, we do have that, yes.
What's your experience in terms of the power of the computer? I mean, do most of the people have computers today, the agents that are well capable of handling the extra capacity from the recording for the resources of their computer? Or is that something where they start then upgrading their computers first?
Actually, it is not that the requirements are not high, really. What is now slowing me down a little bit is more the fact that I do a video at the same time I do a screen share. At the same time, I'm connected to a system based in the US that is more my network connection that's slowing down the process. You don't need a separate graphics card or so. Maybe a real old laptop, 5-6 years or so, that might, if we do the screen recording, might be a bit old for that, because usually those, especially on laptops, you have the graphics chip on board and it's rather small performance. But any kind of, I would say, 3 year old laptop also would typically do the job quite well.
Yeah.
And it also, only, of course, it's depending a bit on the screen resolution that you want to record now. If you have some kind of these brand new Dell Ultra Sharp Whites with 4K resolutions or so, you might get to a point where the network bandwidth needs to be high enough. But the recording actually itself, it's stored at the PC and will be then transferred at a later time.
Yeah, and it's only the screen that's recorded. In most cases, especially in the Avaya world, basically recording of the voice piece is centralized. And so we have a very tight integration with all the Avaya and all the Cisco environments. So that's more done in a centralized mode, and not so we're only using bandwidth, you know, with home agents for the screen recording itself.
Yeah. So Joop, final words from your end.
Yes. Usually, you know, I've sit in a couple of these events internationally, Yeah, quite often people think, okay, it's another American vendor, but you know, we're actually not a new American vendor in your region. Already have quite, you know, a large deployment of clients, of which, you know, you have some of our logos here, which, you know, some of them might be, you know, recognized by yourself, with, you know, top brands as Nespresso and, of course, you know, Zalando. So we're not a newcomer in the market. We have quite a few deployments already, and also with Buchensuder as a partner. Buchensuder has been trained to implement all our solutions. So as a customer of Buchensuder, you can rely on their excellent, you know, customer service and implementation skills. And, you know, where more support might be needed, you know, we're always close by and have local people to assist Buchensuder in deployments. So that's a bit our piece. I think we're right on time. Any questions?